Terry K. Now. 4.4 on the ABV. There's the beautiful crown with the little badger on it there. And this is Dorset. This one, Dorset Brewed. Down there in Dorset, and it says on there, Dorset Brewed. There it is, the Dorset Brewed. Can you see it on the dippling? I love that dippling things. I always love a bottle with a bit of dippling. Always love a clear bottle. Hall and Woodhouse, that's the kind of the business that owns badgers. Right, let's have a sniff off the neck. Quite pleasant. Kind of a slightly wheaty, sort of bready. Rich tea biscuit. Hints of kind of some sort of piffs and zests. Maybe grapefruit and lemon. Let's stick it in the glass and see what I can tell you about it. Now this is available everywhere. Well, in Great Britain anyway. I don't know whether it's available elsewhere. I think I'm going to just pour half of it in. And a bit of plain. Right, a bit of paper behind it. And there's a lovely little mahogany. That's beautiful. Have we got any head to talk about? Tiny bit of head, this tiny bit. Nice carbonation, quite pretty. Let's go in. It doesn't smell exciting. There's a slight tangerine background, but they're all kind of really subdued notes. I'm hoping to get more. See, I love it when you get surprised on a taste. When you get a taste and you get surprised by it. I love that when you don't get much off the outer, you know, off the nose, and you get the palate's like, yes. So let's hope for that. Bottoms up, cheers. Chin chin. Oh, that's nice. Yes, now I'm enjoying that cold. There are toffee notes. There's a harsh carbonation thing. You get a kind of an acidy taste off of heavily carbonated beer. And this is kind of like, you know, them false carbonated. The difference between when you get the real ales, you know, like with the live yeast. Yeah, you get a little tiny bit of yeast on the bottom sometimes. Sometimes you get a big lot when you get someone who's a bit messy with it. But most of the brewers, they just give you a tiny little bit of yeast and this. And if you happen to pour a little bit of that cloud in, it adds to the flavour anyway. But when you get these crystal clear ones, and they're kind of, you know, it's all pumped in there, you get an acidy sort of taste that's, it can be pleasant if it's in the right amount. You have to, a lot of the time, you have to shake it out and stuff like that, you know. But it's got a bit of that in there, which is kind of overpowering the little caramel notes that are very nice. But I'm also very thirsty, and it's biting in the back of my throat and going, scraping away all that birdcage bottom remainings, you know, because I've got a mouth like the bottom of a birdcage and it's getting all that crap out. And yeah, that's doing a good job there. There is slight little, as I said on the nose, there's slight little lemon and tangerine notes there. But they're kind of not singing very much. There's a slight grassy note. Very lovely to drink. Firsty Ferret. Pardon me. Well, that's gone. I'm going to drink the rest of that. I'm going to keep that in the bottle for later on. That is lovely. That is nice. It's kind of, you know, it's what you expect. It's kind of a mass-produced one, and it's but it's certainly nice, and I like that. That's a big boy who's doing the right thing. Really nice, like that. Firmly recommend it. Go buy it and try it. Cheers.